currently, wheelers at large are out again. But it'll be a wheeler at large in a minute. Right. Every now and then, Julie has to do a Saturday morning. It's a very rare occurrence, but it does happen. So, what shall I do for the next few hours? My current speed is, average speed, is 10 miles an hour, because I've been riding around in circles there, trying to keep warm. I don't think it's going to go up too much, because there's a hell of a headwind at the moment. But, let's go this way to start with. Does mean uphill and into the wind, but hey, no worries. Whew. Bit of heavy breathing coming up, I think. Too early in the ride. Wheeler spotted. Not even out of town yet. Bit of a stupid statement. More likely to get spotted in town, obviously. We need an accept cycles there. It would cut out this roundabout completely. The only thing with it is two right turns. Windy! That was something else, wasn't it? He'll push through. Yeah. Sometimes you want them to push through, just get on with it. You know? Nothing scary about that. Kept a constant speed, a good line. I was confident. Well, it didn't get him very far. Let's go. Right, lights ahead. Nothing behind. Hopefully these vehicles in front. We'll change the lights for us. Come on. No. Opposite road, straight ahead's going at the minute. Nothing behind. Anything from the right? No. Let's go. I can mostly hear wind rushing past my ears, but I can hear the birds. Hopefully you can too. This is very pothole-y, this little section. So concentrate, look ahead, nothing behind, room to maneuver. Still nothing behind. Right, take it easy. We've only just started. Let's not go mad. Got a few miles of headwind to do yet. Oh, that rattle at the front. Brake pads. Yeah, I think I need a new spring. Return spring. It's not holding them particularly tight, let's say. Right, car back. Let's make an effort. Make it look like we're trying. Okay. And relax. Right, all clear. All right, what we got? Okay, all good. Whipping the bike around a bit. Right, lean it in. Yeah, all good. Wow, all the old cars are out today. All clear behind. Hole. Drains. All good. Yeah, let's go. Okay, that was Lilliput. Missed out sandbanks. Cut the corner. And now we're heading to, well, Upton, I guess, but we'll have to go via the Broadstone Road and then cut up onto the road at Fleetsbridge. The car behind is being patient, thank you. Okay. Let's go on the new shared path. You'll notice I'm sniffing a bit and my heart rate is high. It's coming down quite quickly, so I'm not too unhappy, but I definitely have got something that's been going around quite a lot recently. Lots of people I know, coughs, colds. It's that time of year, isn't it? Kids go back to school. All gets passed around over the first few months of the year. And I've managed to pick it up as well, even though I've got, you know, all my kids are grown up and don't go back to school anymore. Always take it a little bit easy through here. Dogs, pedestrians, people standing in the bike lane. Please don't call your dog across. Yes, he did. See, a lot of the time, it's not the dogs that are the problem. It is the owners. He actually asked the dog to stay and wait. And they called it across. Oh, well. No harm done. I was far enough away and I was ready for it. You might notice the bike has leant quite a long way over to fight the headwind. It's sort of coming in that direction at the minute. Right, what's this dog gonna do? Okay. direct side wind now. You're going to get a tiny bit of tailwind in a minute, but not for long. I'm going to turn into the wind here, but then gradually go around. Fortunately, I'm shielded by the trees and the bushes if I stay on this side. Should get a tailwind now. Certainly gone quieter. And there it is. Didn't last long though, did it? Morning. Okay, turning back into the wind again. It's going to be a feature. Not a lot I can do about it. Right, is there anything coming? Because I'd rather go on the road. Yeah, all good. Right, how are we looking? Too late, I'm going. Very swirly along here. I don't know what the windsock app will say, but I can tell you it's very swirly. In theory, it should be a cross tail from the left, but it's not. No, that's not helped, has it? Does it even know I'm here? There you go, see? Had to get back in before the white line. Crazy, isn't it? Go on. There it is. Better. Right, fortunately there was nothing behind. I did just check. I had a feeling she was in a hurry. Okay, let's go, everyone. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Nobody indicating I can get in front of the van where he can see me. Okay. Come on, glasses are starting to steam now. All these things we have to think about. You car drivers just don't understand. Full summit, this one. Where the white car is not the top. You do get a little bit of rest before the actual summit, though. Right. He says going left. Right, excuse me. Thank you. That wind is something else. She was loving the shirt. She wasn't, or not so much, let's say. Right, getting absolutely battered here. Right. All good. Yeah, they see me.
These 1% and 2% inclines into this headwind. Oh my goodness. Okay, slightly downhill for a while now. Well timed, sir, good job. Right, camera battery change coming up. No, we're good. Always check behind when there's an island. Yeah, I thought you would. I went wide on purpose there. White band man. You know what's coming. Upper body workout, that's for sure. Right, relax, come on. Loosen the hands. Right, battery change, I think. Hour and 10 minutes in. Hello, yep, hold on. Let's see what we got. Let's see if I was even recording sound. Yeah, it looks like I was. Into Wareham, battery's on the red, so I'm going to change it. Right, that's it, battery changed. I'm outside the Purbeck School, so I'm going to head straight down that way. Still into the wind, but, you know, so far so good. And surely, surely, it's not going to change direction, is it? I'm going to get that tailwind on the way back, aren't I? Right, up the hill first. Don't get in the middle yet. nasty. Okay, nothing behind. Thank you. Have I mentioned the brutal headwind? All right, what we got? More headwind to come, I'm afraid. Okay. Ha ha ha. Right, full on headwind for this one, I'm afraid. Save a bit of energy for this one. No PRs required. Oh, what's happening at the back? Skateboarding into town. Right. Build back up slowly. Here we go. Nothing behind. Try and look for a smooth track in the road. It's just not there. Right. Bit of bum rest. Get comfortable. You've got to go, you've got to go. No, you see, you weren't ready. Why is nobody ever ready? They're still there. Big wide road, what's going on? Go on. Right, nothing behind. There is now. And another one. Right. Do have to stop here, really. It's a main road and we're crossing it. Good that way? Yes. Feel quite right, that one. Not sure they're equal. I did measure them. Maybe I've got odd length arms. So, wind, south-southwest today. I'm heading pretty much due west at the minute, I think. No sun, so it's hard to tell. But, 30 kilometre an hour winds with gusts. Can't remember what they went up to, but to be honest, I'd probably rather not know. And the way I see today's ride is, Julie's working. I think I've got about 4 hours. Now obviously, I have a long list I could go home and make a start on, but as all us men know, you have to think, plan and contemplate how to start that list and the best move forwards. So the way I see it is I have 4 hours of contemplation on the bike. So that is what I'm doing. I wasn't planning on this head bend being quite as brutal as it is. I was thinking coming this way, I'd be in the trees a bit more than I have been. Anyway. I've been trying to practice in the drops. I don't use the drops often. In Mallorca, it's almost a necessity. Yeah, if you want to be railing those turns on the descents, you got to learn to, you know, control the bike in the drops. These last few years have been, nothing behind. These last few years have been the first time in both of our lives, really, we've ever ridden drop bar bikes. So sitting up, moving the weight around the four corners comes quite naturally. But down in the drops, yeah, not so much. And it does take practice. Or I find it does. But sometimes you just hit it right and it's just so wonderful. And then other times you think, oh, I didn't quite get that one right, and you're on the wrong side of the road. Fortunately, it's usually when you're trying to go too fast, and it's only because I can see around the corner that I'm trying to go faster. So it's never been an issue up to now. One time it happened because I had a blowout as I was going around the corner, which pushed me over to the wrong side of the road. Was able to correct it in time though. Come to a stop just as the tyre went absolutely flat. Blowout. Now let's not dramatise it. I had a split, sealant going everywhere, and I did manage to control it and come to a stop. Went down in about 5 seconds, so had time. That could have been nasty otherwise. Other than that, never really had any close calls as such. I don't really count close passes because as long as they miss, you know, a miss is a miss. Doesn't matter how close they are, you know, it's not something I did to make it happen. What's going on up here? Yeah, I'm going to have to let him through. Right, come on, let's go. As nasty as close passes are, I don't think they're the worst. I think they're an easy target for vloggers and what have you, but and it's not pleasant. But yeah, as long as they go by, once they're past you or next to you, they're always going away. So there's that relief there that they're getting further away. I can live with that. Don't think for one moment it doesn't get the heart rate going, because it does. Ooh. Come on, keep pushing. Thank you. How are we doing? One 48, so coming up for the 2 hour mark. Another battery change coming up. You always think when something that nasty happens on the road. All right, let's get through this muddy bit. Thank you. Yeah, then is not the time to have a discussion about it. You know, the adrenaline and everything else is pumping. And, yeah. And that's for both parties, of course, even if one wasn't in particular danger. The adrenaline will still be going. You just got to count to 10 sometimes. Everything calmed down. You just say, well, actually, here I am. Nothing really happened. Let's enjoy the rest of the day. Still nothing behind. Whoa. Smell of the country. Still nothing behind. There's not many lanes quieter than the back lanes of Dorset. Right, long gradual climb into a steep bit at the end. Save some energy. No point trying to burn myself out, not have any left for the tailwind home. That'd be a waste, wouldn't it? Car back. Nearly there. I'm about a stone heavier than I should be. 14 pounds, 7 kilograms, whatever you like. At this time of year, we should have done some 100 milers at least, two by now. But weather and other commitments have really bitten into this year's cycling. Just the way it is, isn't it? Right, nothing behind. Pick your own blueberries. Yeah, so at the moment, the downhills are relatively fast and the uphills are very slow. Still in the middle of the cassette though. Right, there's the lowest gear. Right, car back. Some distance though at the moment. There's one forward as well. Pine Lodge, farm, tea rooms. Oh, that's where they went. Okay, no car back. I don't think I'll go in all the way into Dorchester today. Yeah, still clear. Hey, that wind. Something else. Right. Right, for the moment, this will be a block headwind. I was going west there with south-southwest winds. Now I'm well and truly into it. Things could go quiet for a while. Just heavy breathing, really. Come on, get on with it. Well done. Lovely little villages around here. Right, let's take it wide. Anything coming? No. Right, that's 2 hours. I'll have to check the battery in a moment at the next junction. Oh, what have we got? 2 hours exactly. Will the battery last to the next junction? I guess there's only one way to find out. All clear. Car back. Shouldn't have changed down there. Buckle it. Right, I've done the hard work. Where's that bloody tailwind? Nothing back. Nothing front. Right, let's get around on the road. Okay, all good. Oh, nice. That feels easier. Funny how your body converts, isn't it? For the first 20 minutes, and going down through Wareham into the headwind, I felt horrible. Just unbelievable. Just, oh my God, what am I doing? Why am I doing this? But from Wareham onwards, the body was into it. It's in the zone, if you like. If this is the way you want it, well, here it is. into a headwind again now, so I keep turning south. Better over here. Nope. That's better. Two hours 11, pushing it on the battery. Right, car back. Right, come on. Almost there. Can't quite get my saddle right. Not sure why. Oh, that's not bad actually. I guess when you're my size, you need a little bit more than a few seconds of bum rest. No big deal though. Stop and change the battery in a moment. Right, it's coming up to the crossroads to Morton. Ideal opportunity to change the battery. I'll probably cross the road first.
We've swapped to these chest mounts, as you might know or might not. I don't know if I've really gone over it. And we're now using radio mics. And the whole idea with that is that these are detachable, so we can use them like this, and we can have them clipped in. So we only really have to carry, one camera now. We don't have to have one on a stick and one on the chest mount. But it does cause a lot of faff when you've got to change a battery, because you've got to have the medium mod and stuff on the camera. So, you know, swings and roundabouts, like all these things. It's just the way it is. But I think this is the way to go. One camera each. Only, you know, one lot of footage each to capture and to edit. It just makes the whole process a bit better. When the microphones work, obviously. Okay, here we go, off again. So this is the road into Morton. A lot of cyclists will know this. Nice flat, straight road. Surface is not great, but this is like the back road from Dorchester to Wareham. Very quiet. I think it might be used for the occasional club event, TTs, things like that, because there have in the past been some marks on the road that look like a start finish. I don't think I'd enjoy riding a TT bike along here. It's too bumpy. Yeah, very uncomfortable. Right, car back. I'm staying out of the bump, so there we go. Get on with it. No, they're going to sit there. Oh no, here we go. Saw him earlier. He must do the same loop as me, but the other way around. Oh dear, bumpy, bumpy. Yes, it is part of Cycle Network Route 2. It's funny, isn't it, on a bike? It's only when the tailwind is a block tailwind that it really makes a difference. I'm into the wind again here. Oh, I feel like I am. Woo!
Wow. Oh well, so much for tailwind home. Not happening. See, get in the drops. Easy. Tailwind I was promised isn't happening. Conserve energy. That's feeling a bit better now. There goes the train. No, still nothing behind. Well, last time we came through here, road was shut. Ah, okay. Oh well. No holes, please, no holes. Okay. First whiff of dampness. Yeah, and the discs start making a noise. Slightly different road back to Wareham. The road we just crossed there was the road, or the beginning of the road, let's say, that I took from Wareham before turning off at Walgrett. And this is another way in through Holm.
Pardon me. Wow. Didn't expect that. That wind, every turn, turns south.
recumbent up ahead. See that flag? Crosswind at the minute. Morning. Ooh. So on. Okay, what have we got? Nothing, nothing. Okay. That's it. Listening out for the battery at the moment on the GoPro. I'm into the blue batteries now. They don't last nearly as long as the white ones. In fact, maybe I should have started with the blue. Maybe I'll consider that for next time. Oh, this bloody surface. Unreal. Shake your feelings out. Bum rest, what's going on? This saddle is usually absolutely brilliant. Right, what have we got here? Can't hear anything, it's too windy. Yeah, that's good. Well, we got a 10 mile an hour average when we left, up to 18.1. That 0.1 is very important, by the way. Obviously, otherwise I wouldn't have said it. What a tart. 0.1. 18 mile an hour average now. Definitely time for a cafe stop. Yeah, all good. What are we? 48 miles in. What's that? No, 47. 47 miles in. Yeah, I think that's cafe stop time, isn't it? Right, he's just pulled across. There's probably nothing coming. There wasn't. Whoa! Ah, there's a market. Where a market? Let's go up to the cafe, coffee saloon, I think. Which is just here somewhere. Was. Apparently, Coffee Saloon is now the goat. Coffee done. Let's just check everything's working properly here. It is. It's good. Yeah, a quick flat white. There we go. Right, come on legs, wake up. For those of you that have been around following us for a while, you'll know that stopping is one of my least favourite things. Everything starts to seize up. It takes a while to get going again. So, a quick stop there. And a slow but steady warm-up. Gloves are off as well. It's lovely and warm now. Yeah, no need for those. In fact, I'd probably got away with not wearing them at all.
yet. Let's not get crushed and mashed at the roundabout, eh? That would put an end to the channel real quick, wouldn't it? There we go. I wonder how many times I'll be told there's a bike path. Got 28mm tyres on this at the moment. They're definitely too small for the Dorset roads. Back to 32s for sure. Feel fantastic on the roads of Mallorca, 28, but British roads, I think I'd like a little bit more cushion. Right, come on, heart rate, do your thing. Get the energy running. I suppose the question is always, what tyre? So many to choose from. And if you read the marketing, they all promise the same thing. I like the Specialized Roubaix 32mm tyres. I'm using the 28mm Specialized Turbo
at the moment. Not so sure about these. As I say, on a smooth road they feel nice, but doesn't every tyre? Go on, get on with it. Well done. Thank you. Really? God's sake. Just ran out of patience at the last minute. Thank you, Mr. Frenchman. Thank you. Okay, what we got here? No. Well, I say no. Yes, actually. That's where you're gonna have to leave me, I'm afraid. Last bit of battery. I've put one of the old white ones back in. It's giving me about 20 seconds each time before turning off. What I will say is that this Scultura Endurance just eats the miles. And I think when I put the 32s back on it for the British roads, it'll just eat them more. It is a fantastic piece of kit. That's not to say other bikes aren't, because I don't think there's many secrets when it comes to carbon fiber and design these days. But yeah, this one has proved to be just fantastic. The good news for me is that I've got about an hour to get across town, so I don't have to rush. Oh, and this ride? Yeah, we'll keep it our little secret, shall we?
So, if you've watched this far into the video, thank you for watching us. Click the like button and join us for the next ride.